Geraldine Brooks is a marvellous writer, and her new novel, Caleb's Crossing, is set on Martha's Vineyard, but in the 1600s. Geraldine's a really interesting woman. Grew up in the suburbs of Sydney, the poorer probably suburbs of Sydney, went on to become a foreign correspondent, worked for the Wall Street Journal, wrote a non-fiction book called Nine Parts of Desire about Muslim women in various countries that is still in print and is absolutely fascinating, and then went on to write fiction. The first one was called Year of Wonders, about the plague. The second one, March, which is about the missing father, Mr. March, from Little Women, Louisa Alcott's Little Women. That book won the Pulitzer Prize in the States. She then went on to write People of the Book, which was enormously popular, probably the most popular of all her novels. And the brand new one is Caleb's Crossing. And this is historically absolutely fascinating. She does a huge amount of research. And in her historical novels, she captures the voice and the idiom and the whole tone of the period. So the people, the characters in here speak in the language and tone of the times. It's basically about the first Puritan settlers in the whole Boston area and on Martha's Vineyard, and their original contact with the Native American inhabitants of that area. In particular, it's about this young Indian man, this Native American, called Caleb, who is the first graduate of Harvard University. But the story is told in Bethia's voice, Bethia Mayfield. She's the daughter of the young Puritan minister. And as a young woman, she becomes friends on Martha's Vineyard with Caleb. She teaches him English, he teaches her his Native American language, and they become great friends. He teaches her all the best places to forage for food, the best fishing grounds, the best places that berries are grown, and so on. There's a wonderful evocation of a Martha's Vineyard as a natural environment, wonderful, inspiring place. And then later, of course, Bethia is denied education because of her gender, even though she's incredibly clever. And later she becomes a scullery maid, basically, and a kitchen hand at Harvard University. But there's this lovely sequence where there's a little hatch, I guess you'd call it, between the scullery where she works and the main hall where the young men are lectured. And while she's working in the kitchen, Bethia leaves the hatch open and gets, sort of by default, an education. She learns Latin and Greek. She's very clever. And that whole issue of education being denied to women is explored very fully. It's a marvelous relationship, and in lots of ways, a tragic ending for Caleb and for Joel, the other young Native American who studied at Harvard with him. But totally fascinating. You get engrossed in the period. And for Bethia, not such an unhappy ending after all. So there is something very positive in the ending of this novel as well. I highly recommend Caleb's Crossing by Geraldine Brooks. She has managed in her fourth novel to keep up this brilliant standard that she's achieved in all the others.